Okay, so we're back visiting with the white 1744 model, and the last time I had the top off, and it was not moving, and of course, now it moves just fine. The other thing that I came across was when I tried to wind the bobbin up here on top, when I tried to do that, it would grind and it would not, I got to tighten this back up because I had loosened it. It would not move. I mean, this particular part of the bobbin winder would not move at all. Of course, now, I'll get this back up in here. Now it goes just fine. As you can see, it's turning. You can kind of see it turning there. So to fix that, when I took the top off and I can actually inside underneath on this part of the mechanism is a, for lack of a better word, it's like a washer. It's like a little tire. Now this, upon closer inspection, has got a lot of cracks in it. You can see the cracks on it. This is drying out. This is probably pretty close to the original gasket that was in there. So we replaced this. It's very easy. You just pop it off, put it back on there. Well, then I tried to wind a bobbin and it still wouldn't wind. So I'm going to take this, even though I hadn't planned on it, I'm going to take this off and show you exactly what I'm talking about. So if you have a bobbin winder, you have a machine that you haven't used in a while, and you go to wind a bobbin with it, and it doesn't, the bobbin winder won't turn, then it's probably just kind of like the rest of this machine. It had not been maintenanced, it had not been oiled, or, you know, it hadn't been used in a very long time. So I'm going to take these screws out. I always put them in my little magnetic dish so I don't lose them. And I'll loosen this one over here. There's one right here by the handle, down inside there. It's kind of hard to get to, but once you get it, it comes loose pretty easily. A little bit more. I like to hold on in there. And I'm going to show you what I'm talking about. The bobbin winder mechanism inside. Come on. Get really down in here. There we go. Okay, so here's the lid. And if you turn it, I'm going to do it like that so I don't lose that screw. You turn it upside down. Here is your bobbin winder. This has the new gasket on it. I put this new one right on here. This pops right off. Comes off. Real simple. It goes back on. I found them online, a 3-pack for like $9.99, which is a heck of a deal for these guys. Other people will want to sell them for $4 a piece. So, once I put this on and I tried to start it up, it still would not turn. Well, just like the rest of the inside of the machine not having any lubrication or no machine oil, this was not moving because there was dust up in it, or it's just from sitting for so long. And let's see if I can show you that. Right below that rubber gasket, let me see if I can get it closer for y'all. See the silver part underneath right here? This part here. So on that metal part there, I took and sprayed some dry lubricant. I can't say enough about how great this stuff is. You can get this in any automotive store, and it has to say dry lubricant on it. So that way, you're not putting sewing machine oil on this wheel for it to get oily, because you don't want to get any oil on your gasket because it will deteriorate from machine oil. Machine oil eats up plastic. You put on metal all day long, just not on plastic or not on rubber. So I sprayed this right underneath there on that metal part. I let it sit for about 5 minutes or so. And then I put this back on. And now, as you can see, it turns just fine. So I'm going to put this guy. Oh, when you put it back on, make sure that it's disengaged. Otherwise, you won't be able to get it put back on there. So I'm going to put these guys back in. And if you will remember, in the first video, I was not getting any stitches. It was trying to stitch, the thread kept breaking. Now, there's different reasons why thread will break on a machine. First thing you want to do is change the needle out, put a new needle in. The needle could be bent, and it could be snagging on something in the process and causing the thread to break. The other thing that will cause thread to break is if you put this spool of thread on top, and you know the little cutout notch where the thread sits into, so you can secure it so it's not hanging down like this. You go up and you put it in that little notch so it's kind of locked in. See how it's locked in there? That little notch, if that's on the top, you're fine. But if you have that on the bottom, that notch on the bottom, as it unwinds, that thread will hit that little notch and it'll cut it for you. Well, you don't want that to happen, so that's why you don't, you put it on opposite. So I've got this, where's my thread at? Okay, I just want to make sure that it's in here correct. Pull that up. I'm going to tighten this up just a little bit. I'm going to re-thread it just to show you something else here. When I got this machine, the needle tension was on zero. Now zero is if you've got something like you really thick and you just don't need any tension on it at all. But you want it typically set between 3 and 5. Between 3 and 4 is ideal for regular weight fabrics. And so I'm going to go ahead and thread this. Goes through. There's a thread guide back there. There's one there. Now, what I discovered with this machine, two things were making the thread break. Because this had sat so long, there was something causing extra tension on the thread. Even though I had it on a regular setting, and the thread still would not come through the discs. The discs were stuck together. So it was just kind of riding on the top. You get a couple stitches and then it would break. So again, I took some of this dry lubricant and I sprayed it right between the two discs. So I sprayed it in between the two discs, so now they're not, I mean, I can wiggle them. They actually move. So that way the thread can go down between them like it's supposed to. And my screen keeps changing. I don't know why. I need to close this other window. Come on. I need to close this closed window. There we go. I have an extra window. It keeps popping up on me. Okay, so it goes down between those tension discs. Goes down, up, and through the thread arm, comes back down. There is another thread guide right inside the door, and then there's one in front of the needle. So I'm going to put that in there. Now, I tried to do some stitches in the beginning because I figured, well, now I've got that problem solved. It'll stitch just fine. Well, I was wrong. If your machine ever does something like it starts to do a couple stitches and then you end up with this little rat's nest behind it, well, that's either a bent needle or the tension's off or the bobbin tension's off. So the bobbin tension, to fix that, the way you test your bobbin tension, and this is an old school way of testing it, is you take the bobbin out and you've got the bobbin threaded in there, right? And you've got it all ready to put in the machine, and you hold this string like this. Now, it should hold there, and all you have to do is kind of jiggle a little bit, and it'll slowly go down. That's perfect bobbin tension. So that's how you check your bobbin tension. If it falls to the ground, your bobbin tension's too loose. Turned out this was too loose in the bobbin. So that's why when the thread from the top was grabbing the bobbin from the bottom, it was making this rat's nest. There wasn't any tension underneath. There's a little screw on this bobbin casing right there. And you turn it. Lift it, put that thread to the side, hand turn it to bring up the bobbin thread, just like this, all the way to high position, pulls that thread right up. Perfect timing on this machine. Pull that back, and then I'm going to go ahead and take this. And got stuck in there. I've got to leave my little 4-inch. Now it stitches fine, just like it's supposed to. And a little bit of adjustment, maybe. Figure out, you know, why is my thread breaking? It could be the needle, it could be the top tension, could be a combination of both, or it could be the tension on your bobbin casing. I hope this has been helpful, and if you have any questions or anything about it, please leave those comments in the comment section, and